What's up, team? Before we start today's PE example problem, make sure you like and subscribe, as always, and tell all your classmates, coworkers, friends, anyone who is interested in structural slash civil engineering. Okay, let's get going. All right, today's example problem. This one's really fun. Yeah, really fun. But this one's a good example of something that you might see on the exam. I believe in my own personal opinion. This is something that you could see on the beginning, on the morning session of the exam. So this one's for everybody, not just structural specific. So a wall form subjected to a wind load of 20 PSF is prevented from overturning by diagonal braces spaced at 8 feet on center along the length of the wall form, as shown in the figure. Boop. The connection at the base of the form at point A is equivalent to a hinge. Ignore the weight of the form. The axial force resisted by the brace is most nearly what? It's pretty much broken down into statics already, but let's break it down a little bit further. So we have this thing going on. You have a pin connection at A, and you have another pin connection at the bottom of the brace. And these are located, so I'll draw it even smaller. So what's happening is, you know, you have a wall, some indeterminate length, and what's happening is you have braces, and those braces are spaced 8 feet apart continuously. So that's what's happening, and then you have your wind slamming into the face of this thing. And these are actually, so these are called wind screens most of the time, and these are actually designs that are typical for a professional engineer to engineer. They're always on top of rooftops, and they guard kind of the mechanical units up there. So this actually does happen in professional practice. So it's good to know. Okay, so first thing we want to break down, so we have an evenly distributed force along here, but that's 20 PSF. And we know that braces are at 8 feet on center. So first we got to change that into a line load. So 20 PSF times 8 feet on center gets us 160 PLF, pounds per lineal foot. So that, draw it backwards. So that is 160 along the face of that wall. Next, what we want to know is what is the reaction here? And we'll call that R2. So we want to know what that reaction is, or what that force is, and the subsequent, I should say, reaction here. So this is the force, and that's your reaction at that brace. Well, where you're going to want to go for this is back to your handy-dandy steel manual, as always. So I'm going to have you jump over to, God, I go here all the freaking time. It just, hopefully this shows how handy the steel manual is. So table 3-23, shears, moments, and deflection equations. And we're going to go to page 3-221, and we're going to go to the beam overhanging one support scenario, which, what it looks like, some pin supports with an evenly distributed load on it. And you might be saying, well, that doesn't look like above. Well, actually, if you take, I'll do it in green, if you take this section of it right here, and then you flip it on its side, that actually gets you this, and your R2 reaction is that reaction right there. So, and that equation is inside of the AISC steel manual on page 3222 for that scenario. So that's what we're going to use to find our R2 reaction, because a mistake that you can make on this very quickly is, you know, you're rattling through these and you're pressured and you just say, okay, 20 PSF times 8 feet is 160 PLF. You know, you multiply that times a height of 16 feet, and then that's just your total force acting at that pinpoint, and then, you know, that's the incorrect way to do it. There's some portion, or even if you were to take that force and then just divide it by two, you know, to have a reaction at A and then a reaction here, that's still not evenly distributed between those two reaction points. It's something else. So That's why we need to stay true. And from the AISC manual, the equation is W over 2L times L plus A squared. This dimension is L. Your cantilevered condition is A. That's W. So we have all of our unknowns, or I should say, we have all of our unknowns, but let me show you to them. So L is 10 feet. The total length is 16 feet, so that means A, by default, is 6 feet. W, we know, is 160 PLF. All right, we have everything. Let's plug in for R2. And we get the following. And that equals 2,048 pounds. And you might be thinking, ooh, we're done. Well, we're not quite done yet. And actually, if we look up above, sneaky PE problems, that is an answer already, but we're not done yet. We still need to make sure that we translate that reaction point into an axial force. So don't jump the gun, it's not A. So based on our geometry, we have 2048 pounds acting horizontally, but then we have our brace acting at a 45 degree angle. Let's make that a pin connection. So we need to know now what's the axial force based on that angle. And we'll call that, we'll denote it as H. And so what we can do here is just SOHCAHTOA, and that axial force is broken into both a vertical force and a horizontal force. Well, we know a horizontal force of 2,048 pounds. H is our axial force. Our vertical component is unknown. But we don't need to find the vertical component because we already are given our angle. So we can just do SOHCAHTOA. This is pretty rudimentary, but I'm going to do it anyway in case no one is familiar. We're going to use the CA, which means cosine theta, which is 45 degrees, equals adjacent, which is 2048 pounds, over hypotenuse. And we solve for H, which gets us 2,896 pounds as an axial force in each brace at 8 feet on center. Let's go back up and take a look. That is closest to C. And you know what? We're going to flash it up a little bit with green. Green means good to go. So 2,900 pounds of axial force in that brace, and that's going to be your answer. Guess what? We made it. Another one down, another week, another example problem to prep you for your PE exam. Hit that subscribe button. I know you guys are pumped up right now. You're just freaking jacked up from another successful problem, I know. But until next time, tell everybody that you know, and I'll see you in our next lesson. Later.